Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, I'm not going to show you how to create something, I'm going to show you how to fix something. And if you've ever seen a screen looking something like this, it's some kind of an indication that you've got broken links, so to speak, in your project. I'm going to show you how to rename a project today, and it should be an easy thing to do, but it's not. So let me just walk you through this. So what I'm going to do is I've got this file here, Hello World 1, right? You can see I've done this a few times. I open up the solution file just like I would open up anything else in the world. Takes a minute to build the solution. I go to debug it and let's see if it works. It does. This is just your standard Hello World program, right? It doesn't do much. It has a button. I click it and I get a message box saying Hello World. But let's say that I didn't want to name this thing Hello World. Right, or I decide afterwards that I don't want to change the name, which is the more common thing to do. It's not as simple as just changing a name here or there. So let me show you what I mean. The most simple thing you might do, you notice when I went to open this thing up, it was here and it was in, there's some folders. This right here is the solution file. You could name the solution file something like ABC, and that's really not going to cause any problems. You notice if I just go to click it and open it up like this. This actually kind of works, right? And when I go to run my program, it still functions. But if you notice, there's the old name is plastered all over here. And if you were to start opening up folders, you would see that everything is still called Hello World. All I really did is rename the solution file, which there's no reason to do that in the first place. So what we're going to do is I am going to rename everything. So let me show you what you do need to rename and how this works. So the first thing right off, there's kind of a trick going on here. You may or may not be able to see hidden files. If you can't, I don't know how you want to do this. I go Tools, Folder Options, View, Show Hidden Files and Folders. Once I do this, you notice in the background some stuff popped up back there. So I've got these .suo files. I'm going to delete those. Right, ABC is what I'm going to go with here, so I have to keep using that name for everything else. So I'm going to rename this folder ABC. Okay, going to go down a subfolder, and I'm going to find the .vbproj. Also going to rename that. All right, so notice using the same name for everything. All right, so I've had to rename several things. Unfortunately, we're not done yet. So now if I go to run the program, it's not going to work, right? This is just my standard saying, hey, you download this from the internet, fine. Then I get the old classic message, right? One or more projects in the solution were not loaded correctly. So this basically means I have broken links or file associations, which I do. And I just kind of ignored that message. I didn't do anything with it. And if you look over here at the Solution Explorer, you can see I've got some problems going on here. So what I need to do is I needed to go get the right one. So if I go File, I'm going to go add existing project, and I want to go find that one that I was messing around with before. It's in here, and it's this thing, this abc.vbproj. I open that up. Now in my Solution Explorer, I've got this thing I just opened up, which looks kind of good, and this busted one right here. So I'm going to right click on the busted one and remove it. All right, so now I've got something resembling a program that's going to work. And so there are a couple more steps. Now I'm going to double click on my project over in the Solution Explorer. And I get this. And so I've got to change the assembly name and the root namespace to, guess what, the same things I've been doing. All right, so I've changed those. And that is those are the last couple things I had to rename. And now if I close my project, save changes, yes. Now I'm actually ready to open it up and things are going to work as they should. And so you notice I open up my project. This is the last window I was looking at. If I go to debug this thing, it all works. And if you notice now I've got ABCs everywhere where I used to have Hello Worlds. And I go over here, all my traces are gone, or so it appears. There's actually a few traces left that I need to get rid of, and I'm going to show you how to get rid of those everything is fine at this point. So if I were to go browse to the folder Hello World, and I just want to show you that I can open it up just by double-clicking on the solution file like you always would. Everything works. Just to get rid of those last few traces, those are actually in this folder itself, in the binary folder, in the debug folder. You can see there's still remnants of the old file names in there. So everything with Hello World, I'm just going to delete that. And I'm going to go back up a few levels. I'll just go back just to make things easy to see. And in this folder, in the 86, in the debug folder again, there's a bunch more junk about Hello World still in here. And once I get rid of this, I've literally gotten rid of every trace of the old file name. Yeah, I just smacked my mic. Sorry about that. And that's now I've pretty much cleaned up all the traces, and I have renamed my project. So who would have thought? 6-minute video on how to rename something, right? In most applications, it's as easily as clicking Save As. In this instance, it is not. So you actually have to get in there, kind of get your hands dirty. So moral of the story is, yes, you can fix your projects if you want to change the name, or you want to copy them and call them something else is probably the more common thing to do. But the moral of the story is really just name your stuff right in the first place. It's a whole lot easier.